Welcome back to Adulting Adventures, Economics Edition. I'm your host, ready to guide our contestant through the twists and turns of economic decision making. You remember our contestant from yesterday, Alex.
Hi, B. Great to be back. Let's do some economics.
Fantastic, fantastic. Of course, all of you at home, you too can play along. Whenever you hear this sound, pause the video and record your answer on the game sheet. Let's get started. So, Alex, part of responsible adulting is keeping up with current events, but it can be tricky to decipher what is really going on. In this round, you'll need to interpret economic news and evaluate its importance. Are you ready for the challenge? Of course you are. Here's your first scenario for 100 gold. You're checking your favorite news site and you come across this headline: unemployment rates drop to record lows amid economic recovery. What kind of data would you expect to read about in this article? Those of you at home, pause for a moment and fill in your answers.
Well, I'd expect to see the stats showing how it has changed over time. Has the unemployment rate been dropping steadily over a long period, or was there a sudden drop? I want to understand the trend, not just a single data point.
And once you have those numbers, what next? What additional indicators would you look for in order to help you evaluate what's really going on?
To really get the full picture from that headline, I'd look at whether more people are actually looking for work or if they're just giving up. Then, are wages growing as well, or is inflation eating up their paychecks? It's not just about more jobs, but better ones. Are we talking full-time gigs with benefits or just part-time stuff? And which industries are hiring? It's super important to see if jobs are spread out across different fields or concentrated in one area. That helps us tell if the economy is genuinely on the upswing or if there's more to the story.
Well put. Understanding the broader context is key. Now, how do you relate this news to your own life?
Well, this trend could mean more job opportunities in my field of interest, animal science. It might also influence my decisions about pursuing further education or skills development, knowing which industries are hiring.
All right, Alex. Part of responsible adulting is being an educated and active citizen. So for this next round, you're going to have to use your excellent economic knowledge to evaluate a politician's proposal. It's worth another 100 gold. Are you ready?
Yes, B, I think so. Let's hear it.
Okay, so let's say it's an election year. Two politicians are arguing over whether or not it makes sense to expand public transportation, which is generally lacking in your area. What are some potential benefits you might want to consider when evaluating their arguments?
First off, we need to weigh the costs against the benefits to our community. Let's start with benefits. For example, would the investment reduce pollution and help the environment? Would it make commuting easier and possibly even help local businesses as more people could come into these shopping districts?
Absolutely. But what if not everyone will be impacted the same way?
Well, sure, that can happen. Sometimes public goods are not provided equitably, especially when it's left up to the market alone. So, that could be a good argument for the government to support public transportation in some way. Good public transportation really should help everyone, especially those without cars or those with mobility issues. If a plan doesn't seem inclusive, that's a red flag for me.
Well put. Of course, there is also the financial impact to consider. What questions would you have about that?
Well, obviously, I'd want to know how do they plan to fund this? Is it through taxes, or are there other sources? Are they considering a public-private partnership? If so, what kind of oversight would there be? These are all questions that they should be able to answer. Plus, will this plan still make sense years down the line? It's all about finding a balance and making sure the project is actually helpful, not just an election promise.
Awesome analysis, Alex! On to the next round. This round is all about understanding globalization and international trade, as well as their impacts on our lives. Here's the next question for 100 gold. A global fast food chain opens its first outlet in your town. What positive impact might this have on you and your town?
Well, having a big fast food chain come to our town might be kind of a mixed bag. For starters, it could be good because it means new job opportunities for folks around here. It could also attract more visitors, making our town a busier spot.
And how do you think this could affect local businesses, especially our small cafes and restaurants?
That's the tricky part. Local shops could have a tough time keeping up with the big chain's flashy ads, or they might be incentivized to get creative, maybe tweak their menus, or even lower their prices to compete.
And what about externalities?
Well, it could cause traffic problems with that drive-through. Plus, it shakes up our food scene. Sure, it introduces global flavors, but it might also cause our local tastes and dishes to become less popular. And we don't want to lose our unique flavors.
So, with these considerations in mind, how would you summarize the overall pros and cons of having such a chain come into town from an economic standpoint?
Well, on the pro side, the chain brings jobs, enriches our cultural diversity, and potentially boosts the local economy by attracting more visitors. On the con side, the chain could overshadow local businesses, potentially leading to closures if they can't compete. Like globalization in general, it has the potential for a variety of impacts.
Speaking of, how would you advise our politicians to think about globalization in general?
Well, Bea, when it comes to globalization, I think politicians should definitely recognize the upsides, like economic growth, access to new markets, and the exchange of ideas and cultures. But it's also crucial they don't gloss over the potential downsides, like job displacement in certain industries and the impact on our local businesses and cultures.
Okay, so what can be done about those cons?
Well, the market, government, and international organizations can all take steps to ensure the maximum benefit for all. First off, governments can put policies in place to protect and support local industries and jobs from being swamped by global competition. This could mean funding or working with businesses to support education and training to help folks adjust to the new economy, or offering incentives for businesses that innovate and compete globally without leaving their local roots behind. The goal should be to make sure globalization works for everyone, not just a select few.
That's right! Another great example of how economics isn't just about numbers and graphs. It's about real life and real people. Excellent work, Alex. As we wrap up today's whirlwind of economic exploration on Adulting Adventures, Economics Edition, I've got to say, Alex, you've truly shown what it means to level up in the world of economics. From dissecting the implications of global fast food chains in your town to the nuanced discussions on public transportation, you've navigated through the complexities of economic citizenship and global impacts with ease. But remember, the world of economics is ever-changing. So, to Alex and all of you joining us from home, keep exploring, questioning, and growing. Your economic savvy is more than just knowledge. It's power. In tomorrow's episode, we'll meet up with an old friend, Mia, to see what she's up to. Until next time, this is Bea.
And Alex.
Reminding you to keep investing in your future, one lesson at a time. Hey, hey.